With only a few hours sleep, the crew is back to work. Late last night, Bill made some custom steel wheels while the others slept.
Whoa.
The wheels are in, but will they support the 200-pound deck?
You ready?
Yeah. Go ahead, Bill.
There is a reverse.
Oh, oh yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Now the winch is able to pull up and drop the mower. This is the third starter. Will it finally work? The tips of these steel blades turn at over 4,000 revolutions per minute.
Throw a Red Bull can in there. Red Bull down first.
That went around a few times.
I think the ass end is done.
The Delta deck is devastating, but the door mowers are still not there.
The doors. If it doesn't do 100 miles an hour mowing, then we didn't do our job. It's a failure. You know, if we do something that flops out, it's gonna be, when you hit stuff, it's a broken joint. But if we do something that slides straight down, it's locked. Since we got the patterns for the wheels and everything already, we'll put a track right that. The real mower will be like this. It'll drop down to ground level. Put the bearing on it, it'll bottom out. We'll make it so it bottoms out. Have a dual thing so it doesn't tilt back. And this will go up and suck it up so it's below the bottom level of the door. We're gonna have to come in here, cut all this stuff out, and take some of that 1x1 tubing and basically build a whole box structure so it'll be nice and strong. Tie it into the inside where the hinges are spot welded so we can weld it right to them. Sometimes it's easy to out trick ourselves and make something that's overcomplicated. And there's something to be said about just having it straight down, straight up, you know.
Jesse's new idea is simpler, but it's very late in the game, and the crew only has 10 hours left. George Beers has priced motor-driven door reels, but there's no money left in the pot. A decision is made. The door mowers will be strictly ornamental, a major setback. On this final day, the team must build the new door mechanisms from scratch. They've also decided to add a flame-throwing exhaust system to try and save face. This day, as Jesse James might say, is gonna suck. Mechanic Bill Dodge has gone to sleep. His rather OTT wake-up call is a burnout. The budget is used up, so George scavenges a couple of mower reels from a junkyard.
Should slide out on a slight angle.
Once the motor's going, we turn on the sparker, just pump it, and with all that gas that hasn't been burned up, it'll shoot out the back here. We'll see how it goes.
try the propane now. See how this works.
Five grueling days are over. Cash for parts, $2,994.17. The rear deck is in, the door reels drop, the exhaust system works, and the switchblade is ready for action. But what's it all been about?
That's what I see.
As the shattered crew sleeps, very late at night, master painter Tom Pruitt transforms the Mustang into a shiny, green metal-flaked, fire-breathing dragon.
I'm gonna paint this thing up. We're gonna put green for the money and gold for the honeys. We're gonna top it off with some chameleon flames from House of Color. I think Jesse will intimidate him just with the looks of this thing.
So we're gonna use a Lime Time House Color green base coat. Put some yellow lime flake over that. I'm gonna give it about 5 coats of candy apple lime gold House Color.
It's gonna look like it's going 100 miles an hour sitting still.
Tomorrow, the big test. The switchblade lives and breathes. Now watch the world's fastest lawnmower chew up the turf and eat the competition alive. Here comes Jesse James, cruising by in his green and honey switchblade, hoping that the competition is none the wiser to what lies beneath. Jesse drives down to the end of the grass track to get a feel for the terrain, and he's heading back to the start position. That's Daniel Torres, grass cutting expert, and he's driving a 7-gang tractor mower, tipping the scales at over 2 tons. And Jesse James in his 1990 Mustang GT convertible. The 7-gang tractor and the switchblade Mustang line up. Both drivers are looking remarkably calm, I must say, even a tad cocky. Jesse James is getting his first look at Daniel's tractor mower. And it's big. Look at those 7 blades come down. And Daniel Torres gets his first look at the tire-slashing lawn rocket. What a look. It could well be fear. The engines are revving, and the race is about to start. 3, 2, 1, they're off. Well, Daniel Torres is off. He's taken a good lead on Jesse James, who appears not to be moving at the moment. Possibly a mechanical issue, but you wouldn't think so by the way he's acting. I think we can assume that the ever-confident Mr. James is giving Torres a lead to make this race a bit more interesting. Daniel Torres is halfway down the track, and Jesse James finally puts his foot down. The mower action looks pretty good. The Delta is doing a sterling job, and it's been dragged across that grass at 60 miles per hour. I think Daniel Torres is understandably upset. It's a look and gesture of mutual respect between Jesse James and Daniel Torres. You don't see that often in the lawnmower business. And with a wave, the big Jesse's off to his next Monster Garage Challenge.